I first wanted to start this video off by apologizing for the late uploads. I don't know if anyone saw, I made a community post saying that I was taking 2 weeks off for health reasons. Uploaded a video, another part of the Dream Daddy series, obviously. And then I took me another week to upload a video, as you will see. Having some issues with my health again, and also just not wanting to edit, just kind of putting it off. And also, my editing system was really crappy. I switched over to Premiere because long story short, they were trying to rip me off my other editing software, who shall not be named. I am sorry for late uploads. I'm trying to get back on track slowly but surely. And also, I apologize if this video is really long, but you know, it is what it is. So yeah, enjoy the video. Hey guys, we are back with more Dream Daddy. When we left off, Amanda was making us a dad book profile so that we could talk to all the other dads and potentially get some dates. So we're gonna move forward with making that. On a Friday night, you are most likely to polish and sort my coin collection, Netflix and grill, baby. Fall asleep watching the History Channel, torment my children with dad puns. Absolutely. If you had one thing to take with you onto a desert island, what would it be? My trusty grill, the lost shaker of salt, cast away on DVD for instructional purposes. A boat, obviously. I don't need anything. My survival skills have trained me for this day. This one. What are your turn-ons? Strong dad arms. Tennis shoes with long white socks. A well-manicured lawn. Street smarts. Top-tier chromage. Comfortable with crying. Apps. Yes. Yes. What do you want to be when you grow up? Technical writer for manuals and instructionals. Salty boat camping. Pro skater is also an astronaut. The president of space. Ah, yes. What's your favorite movie genre? War documentaries. Sean Connery's entire filmography. Anything on Laserdisc. Romantic comedies. Old comedies that haven't aged well. Anything on Laserdisc. What's your ideal date? Napping together, doing a 1,000-piece puzzle together, eating a healthy dinner at 4, trying to geocache but getting arson. What do you never leave home without? My sensible cardigan, my sick vape, my book of word jumble, my cripplingly low self-esteem. I spend a lot of time thinking about conspiracy theories, how proud I am of my child, potential ends of the words, will I ever be able to love myself as much as I love my girl. When I get a next cup of coffee, absolutely. Profile complete. See, that wasn't so bad. Yeah, that was actually kind of fun. I could totally spend all day on here just looking at people's profiles. I used to message one of them, or more than one of them. All of these dads seem pretty interesting. Okay, I promise I'll make some friends. Amanda gives me a hug. Go get him, Dad. Run through the finish line. Absolutely gonna talk to Matt. Avid music enthusiast, passionate coffee drinker. You can find me most days selling bean juice over at the Coffee Spoon or hanging out at the park with my amazing daughter. Hit me up about 80s no wave music. On a Friday night, you're most likely to perfect my cold brew setup. One drip at a time, baby. If you had one thing to take with you on a desert island, what would it be? Fine tunes to pass the days away. What are your turn-ons? Multi-instrumentalism. What did you want to be when you grew up? A barista, weirdly enough. What's your favorite movie genre? Stuff with subtitles. What's your ideal date? We go to the animal shelter and seriously consider adopting a cat. Aww. What do you never leave home without? My headphones, both in ear and over ear, just in case. I spend a lot of time thinking about where did writing commas into song titles come from? Where did it go? Did we all just agree that it's a bad idea? I navigate to Matt's dad book page and type out a message. Hey man, great getting to see you at the BBQ. We should definitely hang soon. You free later? A minute or two later, I hear a ding and see Matt's response. Hey dude, I'd be so down for that. I'm actually catching a show tonight at the Soundgarden. Want to come out? I think for a moment. What's a Soundgarden? It's a concert venue, but also a band that a lot of people listened to back when it was cool to have soul patches. Oh man, I haven't been to a real concert since Amanda was born. Am I ready for this? Well, I'm thinking, another pop message pops up on the screen. Pup. Ooh! Ah! I love Pup. They're my favorite. I found out about them because of this game. So that's freaking awesome. Let's go. Pup is playing tonight. Indie pop punk rock band out of Canada. Should be a fun one. I didn't know you were allowed to string that many words together to describe a band. Whatever, let's get out of our comfort zone. No, I want to see what it said. I log off dad book and think for a second. Wait, when was the last time I went to a concert? I mentally backtrack decades through memories of denim jean jackets, morally panic over teenagers turning into the occult. Oh god, I had a mullet back then. Oh god, I thought it was cool. Oh god, other people thought it was cool. I finally remember the strange 80s prog rock I used to listen to. Immensely envision all of the airbrushed vans in the parking lot. Man, how did anyone survive the 80s? That's what I'm saying. So, I haven't been to a concert in a long time. What do you even do at concerts now? I spend most of the day pacing around the house and thinking about my relationship with coolness. I mean, I always thought I was cool, at least relative to a bunch of other dads my age. Dad, what are you doing? I look over and see Amanda at the door, just getting home from school. Her eyes are a little puffy, almost as if she'd been crying. Hey, what's wrong, Panda? Oh, nothing. I'm fine. I just got sad because I realized that society collectively refuses to take pop music seriously, despite the fact that some of the most interesting musical innovations are coming out of that genre. Don't know about that, but go off. Go off, queen. I think it's just yet another thing that we write off because we can't take young women or their interests seriously. Are you sure that's all you're upset about? If there's, you know, anything going on, I just want you to know that I'm here for you, and I'll always be here for you. Whether you need a shoulder to cry on or a strong dad to kick someone's butt, I'm only a call away. Thanks, Popsicle. I appreciate that. But I'm fine, really. I'm unconvinced, but I'll stop badgering her about it. I'm sure she'll tell me when she's ready. Anyway, what's up? Amanda, how do I be cool? Let me put on a pot of coffee first. This is gonna be a long night. No, seriously. Matt invited me to a concert, and I don't think I've been to one since you were born. Yeah, you have. You took me to one once when I was 12, remember? I'm suddenly overwhelmed by the memory of a sea of screaming preteens. Oh god. I tried so hard to forget. The one where I had to camp out with you in line so that you could get a good spot, and then you cried and screamed the whole time? Dad, it was so much more than that. I'm not even ashamed to say it. Oh, you're not ashamed? You seemed pretty ashamed when I found all those drawings you made of those dancing boys kissing in your Trapper Keeper. Hell yeah, go Amanda. We'd love to see it. Yeah, well, you didn't even find the good stuff. Anyway, you should be all set for the concert if you remember that. Just bring a big glittery sign and cry a lot and you'll fit right in. Well, it's at a smaller place, and I think Matt mentioned that they're a punk band? Oh my god, is it Pup? Oh, I really hope so!
Pup is playing tonight.
Like DIY gutter punk? Thrash? Straight edge? Come on, Dad. Give me something to work with here. Are they post-punk? Proto-punk? C-punk? Jeremy Punk? I don't know what some of those are. I know what post-punk is, but I don't know what any of those are. What's Jeremy Punk? I made that one up to see if I could get away with it. What would be post-punk? I don't even know. Like pop-punk? No. I don't know. They're not positive hardcore, are they? Are you talking about like Minor Threat? He said that they're Canadian punk. Oh my god, it is punk! in. Ah! Oh, yeah, you'll be fine. I know they're in the game, so makes sense that that's the band.
You are made of stupid.
Does the idea of Canadian punk seem contradictory to you? I don't see friendship and politeness as core tenets of the punk scene. Well, punk is kind of a big genre that might not be as dangerous as you think it is. It became so much more than just counterculture rebellion. What I'm trying to say is, just enjoy the music. That's it? I mean, yeah, it's not like you're gonna jump into the mosh pit or anything. Well, that's comforting. And if a strange dude in a Set Your Goals hoodie offers to buy you merch, don't accept it and definitely don't go on 3 awful dates with him afterward, where he takes you to a nice restaurant and then forgets his wallet literally 3 times in a row. What? Never mind. Just have a blast tonight. I show up to the Coffee Spoon at 8 in what I hope is concert-appropriate attire. I see Matt out front locking the door to the shop. Hey, you made it. Ready for tonight? Yes, of course, they definitely know what I'm talking about. You better believe it, fellow live music lover. Grab those ticks and let's mosh that new. What? New? Short for venue? You know, where you go to see dope certs. Are you just making this stuff up now? Aw, man, I gotta admit, I haven't been to a real concert since Pet Rocks were cool. I have no idea what I'm in for. Did your daughter make you take her to one of those boy band concerts where everybody holds signs and scream cries? Yeah. I got 2 lined up next month. I still can't get the glitter on my car from the last one. Stay strong. But dude, I get to take you to the first concert in a long time. This is gonna be awesome. Just hang with me, mister, and you'll be good. This scene is super positive. It'll be a blast. Quick question. Shoot. What is scene? Matt lets out a tiny laugh. Sorry. It's just weird because scene can describe a music scene as it pertains to a community of people who like the same genre, but can also describe a genre of music no one wants to admit they were into. Yep. Yeah, I'm been there. Matt looks off into middle distance. What? He says nothing, but I can tell he's thinking never again. That's confusing. You'll get it. The important thing tonight is that you enjoy yourself. Come on, let's head to the show. After waiting in a short line to get in, we finally find ourselves in a small venue with a stage at one end and oh my god, and a bar at the other. Most people here are closer to Amanda's age than mine. I suddenly feel very out of place. My waning youth is showing. I am suddenly aware of my mortality. When were the good years of my life? Will Amanda still love me as we both grow older? Wait, is C-punk actually a genre? Matt, you made it! Younger kid runs up and high-fives Matt. Kid runs off and Matt turns to me, shuddering. I get nervous when people surprise high-five me. Me too. I'm like a small animal. Loud noises and large groups of people frighten me. Do you also enjoy curling up in a patch of sunlight to take a nap? That's my favorite thing to do. A couple other people notice that Matt's in the crowd and yell hey as well. Matt waves and hugs a couple people. He seems really in his element here. Matt turns his attention back to me. I'm so afraid of all these people. Oh? Let's go grab a... Oh, I'm sorry. Let's grab a root beer. YouTube friendly, Matt. Matt and I line up at the bar in the back where a couple of the older concert goers hang out. A couple more people notice Matt and tip their drinks at him. Seems like you're a popular guy out here. Ah, yeah, I go to a lot of shows. This is a pretty, really cool spot. But it's times like these where I realize I can only be charming and funny for about 5 minutes where I run out of stuff to talk about. And then I become keenly aware of where my hands are and that there's no comfortable place in your mouth for your tongue to rest. Gosh darn it, where do I put my tongue? Well, I've known you for more than 5 minutes and I still think you're charming and funny. Just you wait. We grab our drinks. This is... scene. Seems really friendly. I don't know why people wouldn't want to admit that they listen to it. Ha! Let's check out the merch. I thought it was gonna actually show. It's right there! We got some pup hats and a poster, but you can't see anything else. Matt and I walk over to a small booth in a corner of the room where a crusty looking teenager guards a selection of shirts and records. He singles me out from across the room and hops up on his chair. Step on up. Get your merch here. I got t-shirts. I got tank tops. I got all the gifts and accoutrements of discerning concert goer of considerable taste might want. You. I guess you're my shelf. My shelf? Guess you're my shelf. My face flushing red. Let's give him a voice. Yes, you. You look... Okay, I guess we're doing that. You look like a fella who knows their music. How's about a fine 12-inch... I'm sorry if this offends people, but I don't know what other voice to give him. Long-playing vinyl record made and distributed by Pup, Canada's premier punk rock outfit. Please stop yelling at me. I'm already kind of on edge because this is an unfamiliar place and I don't know anybody here. And I would appreciate it if you could stop singling me out. And I'm sure you're cool, but making me a little uncomfortable. The kid immediately hops down off the chair. You got it. Sorry about that. I just get really excited about salesmanship. I can't relate, but I appreciate your enthusiasm nonetheless. Hey, Pablo. Your friend looks lost, so I figured I'd give him the old razzle-dazzle. How the hell are you, Matt? Day by day, my man. They do that thing where they high-five, but also turn it into a hug. Your mom doing better? She's still single. If you want to be my dad, I can make that connect. Have to deal with you every single day? Fair enough. How's your bed? As Mister. Thought I'd bring out a concert pal. Pablo leans close to Matt. Is Mister cool? Matt eyes me. I eye him back. He cracks a smile. Yeah. Pablo brings me in for a bro hug. My dude! Okay, now that he did a bro hug, that makes me want to change his voice. I'm not sure what to say, but give the courtesy two pats on the back, as is customary in our society for people who don't know super well, but still want to be friendly too. I guess like a skater voice, maybe? Pablo's a total card. Kid plays the hell out of bass. Yeah, man. When are you starting our witch house band? You know I'm out of the game. It's a shame. You know Vacant Veil would have slayed. It'll slay once you start actually making music instead of just printing a bunch of band shirts. We got the sickest logo. While Matt and Pablo talk, I check out the merch. These shirts are really nice. Looks like the opener is coming on. Let's get a spot up close. Matt and I walk over to the stage where a crowd begins to form. The band walks on stage and pick up a variety of strange instruments. Is that a harpsichord? The lead singer addresses the crowd. He has a mandolin slung behind his back. Hey, what's up, everybody? We're Jonathan Jones and the Speakeasy Choir. My name's Daniel. Let's start the show. Oh no, these guys. What? Without time to respond, the band starts playing the most cacophonous noise I've ever heard. What is this? Matt doesn't say anything. He just hands me earplugs. Thanks. Put the earplugs in and whatever the hell is assaulting my ears gets a lot quieter. For a band this bad... Oh my god. They sure do seem to be having fun. I guess that's what really matters. Jesus, did the cellist just break his bow in half? I don't get this. This set seems to go on forever. There's no breaks in the songs, and I think one of the band members' jobs is specifically just to burn poetry on stage. Oh my god, I went to a concert where they did that. They were like burning pages of the Bible. I'm like, you guys are unhinged. I turned to Matt and tried to start a conversation. So you go to a lot of concerts out here, huh? What? Ask again. So, you go to a lot of concerts out here, huh? What? Drop it. He can't hear me, so I just stop and try to enjoy the music. Okay, no, this is impossible. How long have they been playing this same song? 10 minutes? 20? A year? Eventually, the set ends, but only after the drummer sprains his ankle during his saxophone solo. What? How? They promised it was part of the act as he was carried off stage crying. Matt and I both pull our earplugs out. Man, that was something. I promise Pup is much better. I just have a lot of questions that I'll never get the answer to. Oh yeah, he sprains his ankle at every show. They were being real about that. That's not good. Let's grab another root beer. Matt and I work our way out of the crowd and back to the bar. More and more people file into the concert space as it gets closer to the main act. It's kind of getting crowded in here. We grab our root beers and try to follow Matt back to our spot. But there are so many people that I'm having a hard time keeping up. As I work my way through the throngs of excited concert goers, I realize I've lost Matt entirely. I stop and look around, seeing nothing but a sea of hip 20-somethings. I'm lost. How am I ever going to find Matt here? Where's the exit? Are there even exits? What if I'm trapped in this building forever? Am I going to see my daughter ever again? What if that terrible band gets back on stage? What if... Suddenly, a hand reaches out to grab me. It's Matt. Almost lost you, buddy. Whew. I got really nervous for a second there. You and me both, dude. Takes my hand and leads me back toward the stage. I can feel myself blushing a little. We finally settle back into our spot and wait for the band to start. Busy place, huh? Yeah, Pop really brings out a crowd. So you go to concerts a lot? Oh yeah, it's one of my absolute favorite things in the world. I think it's one thing to listen to music and connect with it, but when you're in a room full of people connecting with the music just the same way that you are, that's magic. I suddenly have the urge to pee. Curse this tiny dad bladder. I've never heard it put that way. That's really beautiful. Also, I have to pee. Hurry up, man. They're about to go on. Squeeze my way out of the crowd toward the restroom. I really should have gone before I left the house, but Amanda was watching beauty videos in the bathroom. She had an eyeliner wing going halfway across her face, which was actually a pretty good look. I'm so proud of her. I make it to the restroom finally, but it's one of those single-person restrooms with a line forming outside of it. As soon as I finish my business, the band starts. Crap. People that were initially milling around the venue all crowd up against the stage as Pup plays their first song. How am I ever going to find Matt now? Oh great, a mini game. Okay, is this supposed to be me? Everyone's rushing to the main stage to watch Pup play. I'm sure Matt will be up there too. I gotta get there without being trampled by all these rowdy youths. Okay, how do we do it? No! I gotta get there. Oh my god. Oh my god. Get the heart! Oh my god. Whatever. Oh, I'll be over soon. There we go. No! Stop pushing me! Go away! Come on! Come on, let's go! I don't know how long it's gonna take me to get there, but I got a minute. Go away. Don't hit me. Stop. Please. Stop it. Oh, they're running towards me. Go away. Stop it. No, my God. I have 34 seconds. Go. Go, 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 go. Go, 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 go. Go, go, come on. Come on, let me get through. Oh, my God. I'm going to have to do this again, aren't I? Oh, with my ring. Not expecting that. Okay. I'm finally able to work my way through the crowd to where Matt originally was, but he's nowhere to be found. Shoot. Well, I guess I should keep look. I'm bumped into from behind, and I find myself in the middle of a bunch of youths running around in a circle of music. I'm in the pit. How do I get out of the pit? Out of nowhere, a youth shoulders himself into me and keeps moving in a circle. Hey! Guess I'm moving in the circle now. Frantically search for a way out, but all I can see is an ocean of youths rhythmically slamming into each other. Another youth slams into me and I lose my balance. I'm about to topple over. This is it. This is how I die. Trampled under the boots of counterculture. Someone grabs my hand. Someone familiar. I look up and see Matt. He pulls me back up onto my feet. You're wild, dude. Matt throws his arm around me and we jump back into the circle, bashing into youths left and right as Pup plays a great solo. I didn't know you messed with the pit. Me either. I can't believe this. I'm having fun. I'm a little mad that I didn't stretch before physical activity, but I'm having fun. Song ends and the pit finally dissipates. Everybody cheers on Pup. Maybe I only got enough pit energy for one song. Haha, all right, man. Let's retreat. We'll show these kids how it's done another day. We work our way back to a more comfortable spot in the crowd and enjoy the rest of the show from a safe distance. Pup put on an amazing set and especially had to beg themselves off stage after their encore. With the concert over, the crowd starts making their way to the exit. Hey, I'll meet you outside. Gotta say bye to a couple people. Hang outside of the venue until Matt finally shows up. Hey, man, thanks for waiting. I got you a present. Matt hands me the t-shirt I was looking at earlier. Whoa, thanks, man. Saw you eyeballing it back at the merch booth. And I mean, anyone who tears it up that hard on their first time back to a concert deserves a reward. The youths will finally accept me. Finally, I will be able to infiltrate their ranks and defeat them not only on the field of battle, as we have done today, but on a grander scale. We'll see you in the world pit, youths. Hey, Matt. Hey, it's Pup. Oh my god. Hey, dude. Didn't realize you were here. I don't know what his voice is. I forget. I'm so glad I could make it. You guys put on a great show. Thanks. Well, see you around. That was it? Oh my god. Wait, you know Pup? Oh yeah. Met him a couple of times when they first started touring. Good kids. Whoa. Come on, let's grab some diner food. I suddenly realized just how hungry I am. Man, mosh pits take a lot out of you. Matt and I walk to a tiny little diner with a cute neon sign. We turn some bacon and eggs in a corner booth. So there I am in the pit, trying to explain to the face tattoo guy that I didn't mean to elbow him in the face tattoo, but he's already seeing red. Not from the tattoo, which coincidentally was red. He's lumbering toward me and there's nowhere to go. It's the end for me, right? Then out of nowhere, I get this idea. I just lean back and spread my arms. Just like that, I'm crowd surfing away from him in slow motion. You should have seen the look on his face. Bought him a beer afterward and we were cool. We still follow each other on social media. He has beautiful kids. Glad you guys worked it out. Yeah, man. Just goes to show you that Punk's not dead. It just drives a minivan and has to hire a babysitter. So how did you get to see all of these amazing concerts? Oh, I used to tour in a band. We were small, but it got us to travel all around the states. Whoa! Yeah, I mean, we're poor and we had to scrape a lot together just to survive, but I wouldn't trade those experiences for anything. But yeah, that's how I knew a bunch of those people at the show. Music like this builds an amazing community, especially in a town like this. Just a lot of positive energy and good vibes. I got that feeling. Plenty of friendly people, especially that Pablo kid. Oh man, everybody loves Pablo. His mom's been raising him on her own, and you can tell that it's been tough on both of them. I know he looks up to me, so I try to help him out whenever I can. That's really nice of you. Thanks. Us single parents just really have to look out for each other. How's Carmencita? She says she wants to learn the drums. Oh boy. It'll be loud and I'll need to take a lot of aspirin, but I'll manage. Can't really blame her. I'm suddenly very grateful that all of my daughter's hobbies are super quiet. Photography, collaging, whatever it is that she does on the internet. Thanks, Amanda. Trying to be supportive of Carmencita's rebellious phase, but I guess that kind of defeats the purpose of it, doesn't it? I think it would be a good daddy-daughter activity to find something to rebel against together. Like what? Big budget remakes of foreign films. Reading subtitles isn't even that hard. I think we just have to strive as a society to be okay with reading subtitles. Ah, no hearts! That's rude. He and I laugh. We keep digging into our big plates of greasy diner food. The breakfast I ordered for dinner is absolutely a hand in the spot. Man, being a single dad is rough sometimes. It's a lonely feeling. I understand that all too well. I mean, at least we have the rest of the dads to talk to. Yeah, I don't know. I get really nervous sometimes, talking to people. Matt gets nervous talking to people, but he's so cool. Me too. Never really considered myself an extrovert. Never really considered myself an introvert. I'm just comfortable in every situation. You know what they call that? An ambivert. I used to call myself that, but I'm definitely an introvert, so. you're fine. You're actually really easy to talk to, you know that? I smile. Matt and I spend the rest of the night trading daughter stories. Turns out our kids are a lot alike. We finish up our late night dinners and head out. We walk back to the cul-de-sac, back to our respective houses. Tonight was a blast, man. Loved it. Although I'm probably going to feel it in my knees in the morning. Ha! You and me both. I don't usually like going to these things alone. It was really cool to have you there with me. I'm glad. Alright, I'm calling it quits for the night. Stay cool, man. He called me cool. Matt called me cool. Ugh. I walk into my house with my heart in my throat. Amanda pops her head out from her room. Hey, Pops. How's the show? Matt thinks I'm cool. You don't say? Amanda Panda. Matt thinks I'm cool. Blind leading the blind, huh? Wow. I just got dunked on by my own child. Unbelievable. Yeah. Not that unbelievable. Hey, Amanda. Remind me which one of us just tore it up in the pit at a punk show. Which one of us just spent 4 hours probably watching Tiny House Hunting Amish Triplets Extreme Edition? First of all, how dare you? That show is a classic. Second of all, you moshed in the pit? Who even are you? I am your extremely cool dad. Alright, I'm hitting the hay, Pops. I'll see you in the pit. Night, kiddo. Oh my god. Ew. Oh, I got an A rank. Okay, that's fine, I guess. How much time we got left? 3 minutes. Okay. King of care. Okay. While I'm doing my afternoon world jumbles, I hear the mail truck pulled through the cul-de-sac. I wonder if we got any coupons today. The nice mail person slides a couple letters in a large yellow envelope through the slot. Takes a couple of tries for them to get in. Hey, my coupons. I take a closer look at the large yellow envelope. I lightly knock on Amanda's door. She probably has headphones on. Amanda? She yells through the door. What? I have something for you. I'm kind of busy right now. Can you come back later? Okay, just thought you won this big old envelope we got from HIA. Immediately, Amanda pushes her door open. Horn Institute for the Arts? I mean, if you're busy, I can come back. Father, please! I hand her the envelope, which she tears open with her teeth. She has some strong teeth. That's probably bad for your teeth. She doesn't seem to hear me and spits out a piece of envelope. She pulls out a letter and unfolds it. And? The suspense is killing me. This is her dream school. Amanda's face is unreadable. I can't believe this. Oh, honey, it's okay if you didn't. I got in! Oh, I got in! Amanda tosses the letter inside and gives me a big hug. Congrats, sweetie. That's amazing. I'm so proud of you. She pulls away and looks at the letter again. Oh my god, I really can't believe I got in. Well, of course you got in. You're a great student. You nailed that interview and your photography is incredible. Wait, Dad, I know this one's really expensive and it's so far away. I think for a moment. HIA was one of the more expensive schools that Amanda applied to, but I know she's had her heart set on it for the longest time. It'll be tough, but we're gonna make it work. Really? Of course. Amanda hugs me again. Thanks, Dad. Okay, sweetie, we're celebrating tonight. Dinner, your choice, wherever you want. Wherever? Amanda and I walk along the bayside, tearing into our foil-wrapped burritos from a nearby food truck. Could have chosen anywhere in Maple Bay. Cost was not a determining factor. Please, Dad, you know I'm a simple gal. Just give me a burrito with a view. I can't say I'm mad. Amanda and I sit on a patch of grass and watch ships sail lazily through the bay. And the dorms are right near a bunch of cafes, and there are all of these galleries nearby, and there's a discount if you bring your student ID. And Amanda, slow down. You're going to choke on your burrito. I know. I'm just excited. Did I mention that students get their own studio space once they're seniors? And we get all of the professional photo editing software for free? It's nice to see Amanda so enthusiastic about HIA, but I wish she wouldn't do it in between bites of her burrito. I thought I taught her to chew with her mouth closed. I wonder who my roommate's gonna be. You take a survey online and they match you with someone with a similar major and interests. I bet we're gonna be best friends. Craig and I were. A good roommate can be a lifelong friend. But don't even get me started on bad roommates.
Okay, this my timer. So we'll talk about this
next time on Game Rouse. No, just kidding. If you like the video, go ahead, subscribe, like it, all that good stuff. Share it if you so please, because that gets me more engagement and I love that. Yeah, see you guys on the next one. Bye bye. I just wanted to take a moment to talk about the band that was shown in this game, that being Pup. As I was saying and as I was freaking out about, I really love this band. They are my favorite of all time. I actually found out about them because of this game. I really wanted to show you the song of theirs that was played during the minigame, but obviously YouTube would not let me do that, so I had to turn it off. But I will be showing another one of their songs that is a favorite one of mine, and hopefully YouTube will be okay with it since I am talking over it. So yeah, please go check them out. This song that I'm playing especially is amazing, but honestly all of their discography is really good. So yeah, please, 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 please go check them out for me. All right.